Hello guys, this is the fourth example session of the C++ programming related to the using of the C++ pointer object, especially in the character array. Today we are gonna write main function blocks related to the string operations in here. So we can make name as string examples in here, and then we are gonna implement some codes related to the pointers, especially in the character array, or we call in C++ programming string array at that point. Okay, firstly we should include some libraries in here using the namespace of std, standard IO library, to print out some string character on the screen. And we should write the main function block in here, and then we should define some specific character arrays at that point. So firstly I'm gonna make an explanation about the C string library, because it includes some specific operations on the string character, such as the string copy, string cat, or to find the length of the str or string character, we can use the strlen function in here. However, this library is prepared to use some specific notation, but in order to learn or in order to use the pointer object, we are gonna re-implement the codes by using the pointer notations at that point. Okay, and so we need to define the string array, which means that it's a character array in here, and we can initialize as hello world at that point. And in order to add the string character to another string array, we must define some other array as world in here, and we should create the empty array at that point. So in C string library we can learn or we can find how many characters included at that point in string array. So we can use cout operation in here, and then length of the str1 is equal to what? strlen can be used to find the length of the string in here, but it's defined by the C string library in here. And so we can pass the first address element to the strlen, and then we can start this function in here, and we have the 12th character at that point. But we can re-implement or we can rewrite this code by using the pointer notations. And so we can write the prototype, or we can define the function declaration in here, function declaration notation in here, with the return value of the integer function and the name of my strlen with the parameter of const char str in here. This is the function declaration of this code. And then we should define this function in here. MyStrLen with the constant parameter of char str. Const means that this array or the size of this array is not changed the whole runtime operation. In order to find out the how many elements or the how many characters included in this array, we should define an integer point in here with the initialization value of 0. And then we know the str parameter or variable is the starting address of this operator, and then we can use the while operation in here. Yıldız str is not equal to null character, which means that the end of the sync operation at that point, and we can iterate all the points in here with the parameter of i++. But we should add or we should iterate the str point, because the each character must be searched by using this notation. And then e increased at every point until we get the null character in here. And so return I is equal to the strlen, or the size of the or the length of the this character array in here. And we can use this notation at that point, the parameter of or by using the myStrLen function in here with passing by the str1 at that point, and then we can run this program and we get the 12 character in here. This is the standard function of the C++ library, but if we can use or if we will use the pointer character or pointer arithmetic, we can find the size of the character array or string in here by using this notation. So we don't need this library, but in order to compare the performance of our code, we need to use it to compare the whole code is working or is okay or not. This is the first example of the function definition to find the size of the array. But we can implement this code by using another notation. Like, we can declare this function block with this different name, and then we can implement this code like myStrLen2 with the same parameter of char asterisk operator str. And then in order to find out the how many characters is included at that point, we can use the for loop in here. Like, we can define integer I in here, and in the for loop I equal 0, and then we can iterate str plus I not equal to new line character in here, and i++ must be used at that point, and we can take the inside value at that point. And so this for loop goes until we get the null character in here. This is the special idiom to search whole the character in the string array. And then we can return the I value at that point, and then we can compare the other function by using the myStrLen2. The only difference is that this the built by the while loop and this built by the for loop in here. And then we can run this program. And so we get the 12 value at three different mystrlen and standardlen function. And then we can search the specific character of that point. But we need to create the mystrlen function by using the copy function in here. And so we can compare some function at that point with the definition of the with the return value of the bool value, and then we can name it mystr compare function in here with the parameter of char str1 and const char asterisk operator str2 in here. String compare function is used by or is used to find these two strings are equal to each other or not. And so we can use it on cout str1 and str2 are str compare function in here, str1 comma str2 and li at that point. We can run this program in here, and then str1 and str2 are 1. But if str1 is equal to the str2, then the string compare function returns to 0 value, which means that it's true. And then we can write our own my string compare function with the definition of boolean value in here. And so we can define the this function with the return value of bool, and we can name it mystr compare in here, const char asterisk operator str1 and const char asterisk operator str2 at that point. And so we can use the while loop in here because the both string character are constant, which means that the size of these two strings are not changed in the runtime operation. And so we can write this idiom str1, the inside character of the str1 is equal to str2, then we can iterate whole this variable in here because this is equal to each other like this, hello world, hello world, and each character is equal to the another string array character. And so if that is true, and then we need to check, or we can write it down like by using this idiom, and we can use it at that point and we can remove this code. And so we must check the str1 or str2 is not equal to null character, because the null character is the end of the array. And so yıldız str1 equal to null character and yıldız str or asterisk operator str2 equal to null character, then we must return the true value. Because it's true. STR1 is equal to STR2 because at the end of the array we have null character at the same time at this point. Or else we must return false value because it's not equal to each other at this point. And so we can copy all the code and we need to implement the mystr compare function in here and then we can run it. And then str1 and str2 are zero at that point. Mystr compare function in here. And so we need to reorganize the whole code because we have an error. Control reach end of the numWait function at that point. So this code must be outside of the while loop. And then we need to check this code like this one. Asterisk operator is equal to null character and or asterisk operator str2 null character, then we need to break it down because it's not same length at this point. Okay. So we have str1 and str2 are equal to 1 at this point. Because if the both string have the null character at the end of the point, we must return the true value. But in the standard notation, in the standard template library, which means that the str compare returns zero value if the both strings are equal to each other. So we must redefine this function block in here at the reverse operation and then we get the same value at this point because the true is equal to 1 and false is equal to 0 but in reverse dimension in here. And then we can define our own string copy function in here with the return value of char asterisk operator, char pointer operator in here with the name of my str copy in here with the parameter of char destination and const char address operator or asterisk operator in here source. If we are using the my str or my string copy function, we can copy all the source value to the destination value in here. In the example, we can write down str3 is equal to the str copy or string copy function, the destination str3 and the source value str1. Means that if we are performing this task and then we get the hello world in the str3 or string3 array in here and then we have the hello world character. But in our code we can write it down like we must use the integer I value to find whole the notation in here, and then we can give a warning to the user like my str copy is calling in here to prove the this function is calling at that point. And so we can check the length of the both two string, because the size of the string 1 15, but str3 may be equal to the 2, and then we can't copy the str1 character into the str3. So we must check this notation by using the mystrlen function destination greet equal to mystrlen function source. If the destination, the size of the destination is bigger than the size of the source, then we can copy it. Okay, and we must create the for notation in here, and then source value is not equal to null character, which means that it's the end of the array, and e increased at every point in here. And then we must assign dest I value, or the we must assign source I value to the destination variable. And then at this point destination I should be equalized to null character to clear, or the to point the end of the array in here. If the mystrlen dest, or the if the size of dest is smaller than the source one, and then we must printing the warning in here like size of dest is smaller than the size of source in here with the usage of and li operation in here, and we must return the null value at this point because we can't copy the str3 to str1 or the otherwise. But if this is true, then we must say that mystr copy is complete, and we must return the value of destination at that point. And so we can use the our own str or string copy function in here with the usage of mystr copy function at that point. And then we can test it by running program, and then size of dest is smaller than the size of source in here. So we can check this code by debugging operation. Like we must use the size character at this point because the mystrlen dest is difference from at that point. So we must reorganize the whole code. It int dest_len should be given from the out of the scope by using this parameter, and then int source_len should be given by mystrlen source. The problem is the destination at that point is zero because there is no character in here, but the size of the str tree is 15. However, if it doesn't have any character, so strlen function gives the zero value at this point. So we must check or we must give the size of the destlen at this point. And then we must check the destlen and sourcelen in here, and then we must give the specific character of this point is 15, and then we must re-evaluate this function in here. The declaration is wrong at this point because we need to update this function, and then we can restart the program, and then my string copy is calling, my string copy is complete, and we have the hello world at the string tree character array in here. And we can write the strcat function like the string copy function in here. My string cat function with the parameter of char destination and const char asterisk operator source in here. My strcat is used to add string array to another string array, which means that we can this hello and this is the world, and then str3 is equal to what? By using the my strcat function in here with the standard notation strcat, the destination str3 and source str1 is equal to hello world in that code. Okay, at this point, so we have a wrong decision at this point because we need to add the str2 to str1. So we should change the str1 in that code, and it should be str2 at this point, and then we can rerun this program. And so str3 is equal to the this point, but it's wrong. Okay, string 1 is equal to the hello world, but string 1 in the beginning of the program is equal to the hello, but string 2 is equal to the world. And then we can collect hold this character array in the string 1 character array at this point. And we can write this program such as by using this notation. Firstly, we need to have these two string characters or these two integer characters to search hold the character array in the for loop. And then we must find the endpoint of the destination until we have null character in here. And so we iterate the I value in here, and then we can assign the hold the source value until we have the null character by using this notation. destination. I represents the endpoint of the destination. And then we can add the J character at this point, and we need to write this code because source J should be assigned to destination J, but the destination I, the end of the destination, or the whole destination character array should be preserved by using this idiom, because the I is represents the size of the length of the destination and it's the end point of the destination. And then we can add after that point this source value. And then in order to clarify the end point, we must add the null character at this point, and then we must return the destination address in here. Okay, and so we can copy whole this code, and then we can change the name of the function, set array cat, and so we can start the program, and we have the str1 hello world in here. Today our example session is finished, and these examples are, or these examples clearly shows that we can implement every function block by using the pointer notation, because the whole the C and C++ programming are included or are covered by the pointer notation, because the main feature or the main best feature in the C or the C++ programming to reaching the pointer, because it shows the memory blocks at that point. And so we can create the whole the code or the any code by using the pointer notation in C and C++ programming. Even if the it's integer or the character array, it doesn't matter, because the pointer points the specific memory blocks in the computer or the real-time system engine. Have a nice day.